Good morning, student. In our last video, we are discussing about nutritive component of diet. Nutritive component of diet are those diet which provide nutrients, that is carbohydrate, proteins, fat, vitamins and minerals. Today we will discuss about non-nutritive component of diet. Non-nutritive component of diets like waters, roughages, artificial sweeteners, preservative, color compound, etc. First, water. Waters. Our body consists approximately 70% of waters, and the adults should take approximately 2 to 3 liters of waters daily. And in summer we should take more waters as compared to winters, and we should drink safe, clean and hygienic waters. And if there is loss of waters, it cause, if the waters in our body is reduced, then it causes serious problems. Like if there is loss of waters 5 to 10%. If there is loss of waters 5 to 10%, loss of 1 to 5% of waters, if there is loss of 1 to 5% of waters, it causes us and if there is loss of 5 to 10% of waters from our body, then 5 to 10%, then it leads to reduced endurance. Reduce endurance. Strength, etc. And if there is loss of 10 to 15% of waters from our body, then it leads to dehydration. Dehydration, body pain, lethargy, acne, etc. And if there is loss of 15 to 20% of waters, then it leads to 15 to 20%. If there is loss of water 15 to 20, then it leads to blurred vision, loss of memory, faint, etc. And if loss of waters more than 20%, then it leads to death. This is about the waters. Okay, our body consists approximately 70% of waters, and if there is loss of waters 1 to 5% loss of 1 to 5% of waters from our body, then it leads to thirst. 5 to 10%, it leads to loss of our strength, endurance. And if there is loss of 10 to 15% then it leads to dehydration, body pain, body ache, etc. And 15 to 20% it leads to blurred vision, loss of memory, pain, etc. And if it is more than 20%, then it leads to death. Next is importance. What are the importance of waters? There are many importance of waters in our life, like regulate body temperatures, body waters, it's help to maintain and regulate the body temperatures in our body. Transportations of important nutrients in our body. Waters helps to transport important nutrients in our body through blood, like waters, water soluble vitamins, etc. Okay, waters itself in transportations of important nutrients in our body, maintain body fluid, waters helps to maintain the body fluids in the body. It helps in digestions, absorptions, circulations, proper circulations, secretions of saliva, etc. Eliminate body toxin. Waters help to eliminate body toxin, helps to eliminate waste product from our body. Lubrication of joint. Waters help in lubrications of joint. Thus, it helps to improve the flexibility. The chance of injury will be less. Okay, the lubrications, there will be the flexibility in the joint. Therefore, it helps to reduce sprain, joint injury, etc. Improve skin quality. Water, it has to improve the quality of the skin by removing the toxin from the skin, waste product from our skin. Our quality of the skin will improve. Okay, it has to keep the skin looking good and beautiful. Improve kidney functioning. Waters helps to improve the functioning of the kidney. It's helped to by drinking waters. It's helped to remove the waste product from the kidney. Therefore, our kidney will function properly. Maintain electrolyte balance. Boost the physical performance. boost physical performance by doing physical by drinking sufficient waters. Our physical performance will be improved and improve digestion. If we drink sufficient waters, then our digestions will improve. It's help in improving the digestions. It's help to prevent constipations, etc. These are the some importance of water. Next is roughest or we can say fiber. Next, roughest or we can say fiber. Okay, roughest or fiber. Roughest, it is also known as fibers. Fibers, it is an indigestible portion of the food. This cannot be digest, but it help in digestion. Okay, roughest, it is an indigestible portion of the food which cannot be digest, but it help in digestions. Roughest, it come from plant based food. Okay, we get from the plant which cannot be digest, but it help in digestions. It help in digestions, prevent constipations, etc. Roughest add bulk to the food, so it satisfy the hunger. This is about the roughest, or we can say fibers. Fibers, it is an indigestible portion of the food. Indigestible. Indigestible portion of food. Indigestible portion of food which cannot be digest, but it help in digestions. It help to prevent constipations, etc. Roughest, it comes from plant waste. Plant based food, we get roughage from the plant based food. Roughage add bulk to the food, and it satisfy hungers, appetite, etc. Next is artificial sweeteners, preservatives, etc. These all are the non-nutritive component of diet. Okay. Artificial sweeteners, preservative, color compound, waters, roughage. These all are the non-nutritive component of diet, which does not provide nutrients, but it's help in proper functioning of our body. Artificial sweeteners. Artificial sweeteners, it is usually taken by the diabetes patient. It gives the taste of sweet. Okay, these are low or no calories and provide sweet taste, and taken by the diabetes patients as alternative to the sweet. Next is preservative. Preservative, it is mainly used by the food industries to preserve their food. Preservative, it helps to store the food for long period of time. Okay, preservatives, it helps to store the food for long period of time. So it is used in the food industry to keep the food preserved. So we should use good quality preservative. Okay, we should use good quality preservative. And color compound, it gives you the color. Waters, our body contain 70% of waters. Waters, it's helping transportations of important nutrients, maintain water balance in the body, eliminate body toxin from the body, lubrications of joint, improve the quality of the skin, etc. And roughage, it is an indigestible portion of food which cannot be digest, but help in digestions, it's help to prevent constipations, etc. While roughage we get from the plant-based food, okay, and it's add bulk to the food, and that will be the it satisfy appetite, will not feel hungry. Next is eating for weight control. How to prevent obesity? Eating for weight control. A stable weight depends upon a balance between the energy we get from the food and the energy we use. Okay, balance weight depends upon the energy we use, energy which we get, and the energy which we use. Okay, a stable weight depends upon a balance between the energy we get from the food and the energy we use. And overweight, if a person consume more calories than they use, okay, if the person consume more calories and use less energy, then it leads to overweight. Okay, when a person consume more calories than they use, it leads to overweight. And underweight situations, the persons consume less calories and use more. Okay, when a person burn more calories, he do heavy workout, he burn more calories than he get from the food, then it leads to underweight. Okay, this is about balance. The balance weight depend upon a balance between the energy we get from the food and the energy we use. Overweight occurs when we consume more calories but we use less. And underweight, it occurs when we get less calories. Okay, we take less calories but burn more. Okay, we take less but burn more. Okay, we burn more calories than we take. And BMI, body mass index. Body mass index, it's help to find out BMI, that is body mass. Body mass index, it's help to find whether the person is underweight, overweight, or normal weight. And according to that, a person can do a physical workout, they can take a diet to gain or reduce the weight. And the formula for body mass index, how we can find our BMI, is weight. trade upon height square. Weight we take in kg or gram, and weight we take in meters or centimeters. Okay, this is about the formula to find out the BMI. BMI helps to find out whether the person is underweight, overweight and or normal weight, and according to that we can take a diet, we can do a workout to reduce or to gain the weight. And after finding out the BMI, weight upon height square, weight we take in kg or gram, and height we take in meters or centimeters. After finding out the BMI, we compare the BMI with these norms. With this norm category man, woman. If the BMI for underweight, normal weight, overweight and obese. If a person BMI is less than 20, if a BMI is less than 20, it means that he is underweight. And if it is between, BMI is between 20 to 25, it means the person is fit and healthy. And if it is between 26 to 30, it means the person is overweight. And if it is more than 30, means the person is obese. And for women, less than 19, if the BMI is less than 19, underweight, 20 to 25, okay, 19 to 24 means she is normal. 25 to 30, it means she is overweight. And if it is more than 30, it means she is obese. This is the formula to find out whether the person is underweight, normal weight or overweight, and how you can control your weight. There are some tips to control your weight, like by taking proper balanced diet. By taking proper balanced diet, we can reduce the weight. Eating more fibrous food, that is eating more fiber, because fibers it's helping digestions, etc. Tips for weight control. First, balanced diet. By taking proper balanced diet, a person can maintain his body weight. Balanced diet. Diet means the food which we eat, and balanced diet means the diet which contains all nutrients, carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals in a correct proportions. And by eating proper balanced diet, we can maintain our body weight. Eating fibrous food. By eating fibrous foods, like fibrous food means plant-based food like fruits, vegetables, green leafy vegetables, salad, etc., we can control our diet, because fibrous foods It satisfies our hungers as well as it helps in digestions. Avoid fat. Avoid fat. If you want to reduce your weight, avoid fat. And if you want to eat fat, take unsaturated fat. Fat, there are two types of fat, saturated fat and unsaturated fat. Saturated fat we get from the animal product like ghee, butter, and unsaturated fat we get from the plant product like coconut oil, refined soya oil, etc. So if you want to take fat, take unsaturated fat. Do physical activity. Do regularly the physical activity. Physical activity, it's help to reduce the weight as well as it's help to keep you fit and healthy. It will keep you energetic, active. So do physical activity continuously. Avoid junk food. Avoid junk food. Okay, don't take junk food like cold drink, pizza, Pepsi, burger, pasta, etc. Do medical checkup. Okay, do medical checkup. At least one in a month, do a regular medical checkup. We should regularly go for medical checkup after every 6 months. Medicine. Only after doctor advice. Doctor. Without doctor advice, don't take any medicines. If you want to take medicine, first take a advice from the doctors. Okay, never take any medicine without doctor advice. Pitfall of dieting. Pitfall of dieting. Never do pitfall of dieting. People usually to reduce their weight, they start avoiding food which affect their health. So avoid pitfall of dieting. Avoid smoking, drinking, drink sufficient waters, If you want to reduce your weight, drink sufficient waters. Waters will also help in digestions, etc. So drink sufficient waters. Make small sip. In place of taking a heavy meal at one time, it better to take the meal in a small sip throughout the day. Okay, the diet should be taken in a small sip throughout the day rather than taking a heavy meal at one time. Follow hygienic habit. Always follow hygienic habit. Clean your food, hand, eat fresh food, etc. Do not fast. People usually to reduce the weight, they start doing fasting, which affect their health. So never do fasting. If you want to reduce your weight, do physical workout. Never try swimming pool. Never try swimming pools. People, to reduce their weight, they start taking medicine to reduce their weight, which affect their health. So never take any swimming pills. We should never try any form of swimming pills, medicine, drugs, etc. for reducing the weight. These are the some tips to control your weight. Okay, so today we have discussed about non-nutritive component of diet. Non-nutritive component of diet like waters, roughage, artificial sweeteners, preservatives, etc.